No fighting, no fighting, no fighting, no fighting. 6:42, it is Valentine in the morning. This is 104.3 MyFM. If you go on my Instagram, at GoForValentine, you see it was like birthday and anniversary central this past week or so. And my wife's birthday was on March 29th. The kid's birthday was on April 8th. My anniversary was yesterday. It's a tough first quarter or so. Oh, my gosh. Happy anniversary, by the way. Thanks, bro. First to say it. Appreciate it.
Happy anniversary.
Oh, second to say it. Loving it.
Yes.
Well, now I'm the turd.
Oh, dear.
The what? That's not an on-air thing. That's an off-air joke. Thanks for bringing that one on air. So anyway, with that being said, if you see these photos, and it's funny how this one last time anniversary didn't get that many likes. I think it's because it's kind of, I don't know, I look like Morrissey in bad shape in this photo. You know?
You look good.
No, I don't think I look good, but I didn't care because my wife looks good. It was cute. It was the two of us. That's what an anniversary photo should be. So I don't mind if nobody likes it. But anyway, I put something down, and this will be good for first sip today, because Kevin was sitting here talking about, you know, his kids being back in school, and Brian said something, which might have been an off-air comment, like, oh, thank God I'm back at work. I needed a break.
It's true. I needed to be around just adults.
Right. And so my kid turned 13. I think this will be good for first sip. And what is first sip, Kevin? Somebody's listening for the first time today.
It's how we start the day around here. Val shares a positive thought. It could really be about anything. And then we all raise our cups high and toast the day ahead with that first sip as a community.
And it was funny because when I read this off the air a second ago, Kevin gave me a tremendous compliment. Actually, one of the best compliments he's ever actually given me.
When I read your little, you know, blurb there about Colin's birthday, I assumed you copy and pasted that from some famous poet or something, honestly.
And it's not that. It was just me by the sea with a glass of wine in time. That's all it was. I wrote, someone did not turn 13 today. It's currently embargoed with an expedited request for a formal hearing with Father Time. Little joke there, right? Oh, how I wish I could slow this ever-determined march to becoming a man. Once it felt like the tortoise was a captain of the ship, but now he has handed the controls to his friend the hare. And so time does exactly what it was designed to do. So we'll enjoy the new scenery as it presents itself to us. We'll strive to make new memories to add to the old and never forget when 13 was 3 running to the door yelling daddy.
Very
don't forget
sweet.
It, boys. Don't forget
powerful.
It.
Powerful.
It goes by so, so fast. And someone older than me, with a kid who's in college or graduated or started their own family, will look to me and say the same thing to me. Enjoy that 13. It goes by so very fast. So to each and every generation that is behind us, coming up with their kids, enjoy it. There'll be stressful days, of course, but it goes by in the blink of an eye. Just the other day, I was 21, sitting in a bar in Groton, Connecticut, trying to hit on a girl. Now look at me.
How'd it go?
Sweet.
Finish that story. How'd it go?
Not very well. Count us up, Jill.
1, 2, 3.
When 13 was 3, yelling daddy. There you go. There's a back to the sweetness. No, finish the story about the bar at 21.
I'm not your friend or anything, dear. You think that you're the man. I think therefore I am. I'm not your friend or anything, dear. You think that you're the man. I think therefore I am.
Stop. What the hell are you talking about?
Get my pretty name out of your mouth. We are not the same with or without. Don't talk about me like how you might know how I feel. Top of the world, but your world isn't real. It wasn't ideal. So go have fun.
I really couldn't care less, and you can give it my best, but just know
I'm not your friend or anything, damn. You think that you're the man. I think therefore I am. I'm not your friend. Put your name next to mine, we're on different lines. So I wanna be nice enough, they don't call my bluff, cause I hate to fight. Articles, 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 rather you remain unremarkable. Interviews, 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 when they say your name, I just like, did you have fun? I really
really couldn't care less, and you could give him my best, but just know.
I'm not your friend.
It is 104.3 MyFM. Coming up 7 o'clock, your chance at $1,000 easy money. That is back on MyFM, and it's very simple. We're not going to force you to pull over to the side of the road and text in like some of you were doing, and some of you were illegally texting while you were driving and stuff. We're going to give you a word. You go on the website when you get a chance, when you get to the office, while you're at home, whatever it is. It'll be there for about an hour, I think, right? You take that word, you enter it on our website, 104.3MyFM.com. You're automatically in the running for $1,000. Boom, just like that.
Yeah, it's so easy. And I mean, if you kind of have that like little page saved, it's 1043myfm.com/easymoney. You just open your phone and, you know, it's so easy to pull up and you just, it takes you 2 seconds.
Right, yeah.
And we have 12 chances a day for you to win that money.
Yeah, so it's a lot of cash.
Yeah.
Staples Center Lakers have released a set of guidelines for fans to return to Staples Center as they prepare to welcome fans back. Thursday night, they host the Celtics. People will be attending the game, but you must show proof of final vaccination. And fans will be required to show they live here in California as well. So you got to show final vaccination and you live in California. I don't know, which we'll find out when they say final vaccination. Let's say you get your Pfizer or your second Pfizer shot today. Does that count or do you have to wait 2 weeks? Because they say for Pfizer or Moderna, it's 2 weeks after your second shot that you're quote unquote fully vaccinated. Johnson & Johnson, I don't know how much time after that first shot. It's a one shot anyway, until you're fully vaccinated.
Right.
And AstraZeneca, you're probably not getting it. So I don't know what that means. But we'll look into it and let you know, because a lot of people are excited to see the Lakers play, to be there, to be a fan. There's a cardboard cutout sitting on the couch of me wearing Dodgers gear, because they had this at Dodger Stadium, but now they have all fans there. They've let fans back in.
Yeah.
So they don't need the cardboard cutouts. So what do? They gave them back to people.
That is so strange that they redistributed them. That's, I wouldn't expect that.
It's been sitting there in the nasty stadium for how long? Who knows what's on that thing? But it's actually wrapped up in plastic and returned. I thought the Dodgers did a solid with that. How nice is that, right?
That's so nice.
Dodgers are just a class act. Thanks for doing that, guys.
Here's what's coming up
in Hollywood headlines.
Buckingham Palace has released a statement explaining why Meghan Markle will not attend Prince Philip's funeral. I'll tell you why right after traffic.
This traffic report is sponsored by Visit California. There's problems in Diamond Bar, southbound side of the 57, just before you get to the 60. Four cars that are tangled up. They're saying one of those is still in the middle lanes. Everybody else made it out to the right shoulder. So watch for heavy delays there at Temple. That's going to save busy up head all the way out towards Brea Canyon, and then it gets better before you reach the 91. Speaking of the 91, westbound side of the 91, just past Green River, an accident there that's blocking the left lane of the main line. That's adding to an already tough drive as you leave Corona from the 15 freeway. Past that crash, it's pretty smooth sailing as you make way into Orange County. And then westbound 91 does slow down again as you get through the North Long Beach Compton area. From the 710, you're going to see brake lights over towards the 110 freeway. Southbound side of the 110 slows just before the 91. That stays busy to the 405, where northbound 405 just past the 110. They're running a traffic grid to clear some debris from the roadway. Calling all Californians, keeping your vacation here helps the entire economy get back to work. And when you're out exploring this big, beautiful state, please travel responsibly. Find ideas and information at visitcalifornia.com. California, dream big. That's your traffic. I'm Tony Jordan with Valentine in the Morning on 104.3 My FM.
Hollywood headlines.
Prince Harry is in England for Prince Philip's funeral, but his wife, Meghan Markle, will not be attending, and Buckingham Palace issued a statement saying that she is staying back in California.